and Kenzie, thank you all for being here to celebrate this special occasion with them. This wedding ceremony is a celebration of marriage between one man, Jake, and one woman, Kenzie. Today we're celebrating alongside Jake and Kenzie because of the covenant they want to make with each other and with God to love one another wholeheartedly for the rest of their lives. Join me in prayer as we begin this ceremony. Heavenly Father, we just are so overjoyed today at just your goodness, Father, and the way that you have brought Jake and Kenzie together. Lord, you deserve all the praise and the glory for that. God, in this ceremony, I pray that you will be glorified and we will just get to watch as two people who love you come together to serve you for the rest of their lives. So Lord, bless this time together in Jesus' name. Amen. Who gives this woman to be with this man?
Her mother and I.
You all may be seated. So Jake, Kenzie, today is the day. It's the day that you all have committed to make the marital covenant with each other, God himself, and these friends and family as your witnesses. But before we make any verbal commitments, let us be reminded by the word of God what marriage is and how it works. It's important for all of us to understand that God created marriage, and he loves marriage, and he desires your marriage to be all he created it to be. So in the very beginning, after God had spent days creating all things by the breath of his mouth at creation, there was still one thing that was not good. Let's take a look at Genesis 2, 18 through 25. It is not good for man to be alone. I will make him a helper suitable for him. Now out of the ground, the Lord God formed every beast of the field and every bird of heaven and brought them to the man to see what he would call them. And whatever the man called every living creature, that was its name. The man gave names to all livestock, to the birds of the heaven, to every beast of the field. But for Adam, there was not found a helper suitable fit for him. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man. And while he slept, he took one of his ribs and closed up his place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman and brought her to the man. Then the man said, "This at last is bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man. Therefore, a man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast to his wife,